Prince Harry has been accused of suffering from a lack of rich person's self-awareness over his decision to collaborate with Vogue magazine. Meghan Markle last month was announced as the guest editor of Vogue's September issue following months of speculation over her involvement with the publication. The Duchess of Sussex's husband Prince Harry also made a surprise appearance in the magazine through an interview with British conservationist Jane Goodall. But the couple came under fire over their spectacular failure of rich person's self-awareness. Commentator Tom Slater told Talk Radio, "Meghan and Harry have this reputation for being a little bit snooty, and even the fact they worked with the magazine and the editor of the magazine referred to Meghan Markle as the greatest force for change, I think it's the perfect encapsulation of how topsy-turvy identity politics sometimes makes this discussion. You've got a member of the royal family, this old, feudal throwback who is suddenly held up as something incredibly progressive because now she writes opinions and anyone who dares challenge their elitism is somehow cast as some sort of nasty racist. It shows how topsy-turvy this whole discussion is, that you have someone that privileged who are effectively given the privilege of protection from criticism." Royal commentator Dan Wooten appeared to agree with the assessment, insisting Meghan Markle and Prince Harry should not have worked with the elite magazine. Mr. Wooten said, "One of the things I was actually most disgusted about with this guest edit is the fact that Meghan Markle did choose to do it in Vogue magazine, which is a magazine for the elite, for the rich, for the skinny. Where most outfits in there cost thousands of pounds and totally out of reach from ordinary Brits, even the fact that the magazine cost nearly £5 makes it very clear that only very rich people will be buying it." The Duchess of Sussex chose to frontline her guest-edited issue with female trailblazers she identified as forces for change. Among the women selected to feature on the cover were former First Lady Michelle Obama and 16-year-old environmental activist Greta Thunberg. Royal correspondent Roya Nika claimed the decision to include the young activist was punchy. Ms. Nika said, "I have to say I thought Greta Thunberg was quite a punchy one. I know she's the poster girl, at the moment, of the environmental and climate discussions, but she's a political figure. She's a very political figure, there's no two ways about it. By putting her on there sends a very strong message from the editorial stance and from Meghan. We know they are conservationists, we know they are very interested in the environment, we know that from their Instagram posts, from the speeches both of them give. But Greta Thunberg and the Extinction Rebellion movement that we saw here over the summer was pretty divisive, it rammed home into the sphere of politics, that's a punchy thing to choose." Institute of Public Affairs's Gideon Rosner earlier this month told Sky News Australia, "I don't think it's a good idea for any royal to be this active in the climate debate. In a constitutional monarchy, the royal family should be apolitical, this is not some universally accepted position, this is a serious economic issue for Britain. Britain will have to debate serious parliamentary measures that will be a huge handbrake on its economy." Former Prime Minister Theresa May committed to reducing greenhouse gas emissions by 2050 in an effort to leave this world in a better condition than what we inherited, but the issue is set to remain contentious over the next few years. Mr. Rosner added, "I don't think it's right that anybody from the royal family is interfering in the deliberations of a democratically elected parliament."